It was a liberated marriage. We shared the household chores, of course. We understood each other's feelings right down to the day of our sensible divorce. I didn't ask him for a penny. I'd had my liberated training. So off he went with his hair of bronze to find a life like Khalil Gibran's. I got my rest from the drugs he did. He got his quest. I got the kid. And oh, I'm not complaining. Set off to be a writer, a modern mother on her own. I wrote up happenings at galleries, turned down jobs with salaries, stayed freelance and alone. I fought the battles of the 60s, which you recall were rather draining. When men were thick, I hit the fray, became a prick, got equal pay. I faced down chauvinistic slobs. I won the fights, improved the jobs. And oh, I'm not complaining. Pounds and went through hell. Then one day he came back from limbo, found himself some bimbo, and moved to New Rochelle. I raised my son and I had lovers. My choices sometimes take explaining. I'd meet some jock, my friends would scoff, he'd stay a while. Drive him off. I kept my space, preserved my turf. 6 months, I'd send him back to surf. And no, I was not complaining. So now my son's halfway through college. I pay tuition like a fine. Still, this feisty freelance writer, resume well honed at a well toned 49. I find that getting work is harder. Each job I want takes more campaigning. And those sweet young things who hire me now, those MBAs making 90,000, who smile and ask what I have done when they got their fights from the jobs I won. They should all stay home and have babies. But I'm not complaining. And in the evening at my window, as I watch Jersey growing dim, I feel a troubling emotion summed up in this notion. I wish I'd stayed with him. Lord knows each day with him was madness. As I have spent my life maintaining, but more and more I recall the joy, my golden dreamer, my lost boy. life was life in the twilight zone. But no worse than a life alone. And oh, well, I chose my way. I'm not complaining.